to take a look back at our program and improve our code by making a more efficient square. This is called refactoring. Developers do this to make improvements to written code while making sure it still runs correctly. Let's use a loop to make an easier square. A loop repeats a series of blocks as many times as you want. Instead of using 8 blocks, you can write the same square program using only 4 blocks. To reduce the number of blocks, start by deleting all but one of the roll and delay blocks. Long press or right-click and select Delete This Block. You can also select the top block of a group of blocks that you want to delete and drag it to the red garbage can at the bottom of your screen. If you accidentally delete a block that you didn't mean to, you can click the Undo button in the bottom right to undo the last action, and keep clicking to get back to previous versions. You can also redo. Now you can add a loop. Open the Controls category. Control blocks, also known as control flow, allow you to change the flow of a program and add conditional logic around the blocks. Drag the loop block over the remaining roll and delay block. A loop enables you to nest other blocks within it and repeat those blocks as many times as you want. A square has 4 sides, so you want this loop to repeat 4 times. The last thing you need is a method to change the heading angle on each side. You will use what's called an operator for this. An operator is a math statement that changes a number, like addition, multiplication, or division. In this case, for each side of the square, you simply want to add 90 degrees to the heading angle each time you repeat the loop. So go to the Operators category and locate Basic Operator Block. Notice that you can change the operation by tapping on the drop-down arrow. Now, drag it to the heading field. You can now see there are 2 fields to define the heading angle instead of just 1. Go to the Sensors category. Select Heading and drag it into the left side of the operator statement. Tap on the bubble to the right of the plus sign and enter 90 for 90 degrees. This statement reads as, add 90 degrees to the current heading angle each time through the loop, just like you manually built in your first square program. Because this is a more complicated line of code, programmers often use comments to annotate what their code does so others can understand it. You can add a comment on this block by long pressing or right-clicking and selecting Add Comment. Leave a comment like, adds 90 degrees to the heading each time through the loop. You now see the comment attached to the block as well as in the JavaScript code. Time to run the program. Okay, same setup as last time. Place Sphero on the ground, aim it, then hit the start button. Your robot should perform the same square as the first one you made. But wait, it looks like it's turning to the right, or 90 degrees first, instead of going straight at 0 degrees. Do you know how to fix this? You can fix it by adding a block before the loop start, which sets the initial heading to 270 degrees. That way, the first time it runs the loop, the heading angle will equal 270 plus 90 equals 360 degrees, which points the same direction as 0 degrees or straight forward. Go to the Movements category and drag a heading block to the canvas above the loop. Set it to 270 degrees. Test your new program and make sure it works. Not only is writing the square this way more efficient in blocks, but it also is more powerful. For example, if you wanted to have the square repeat 2 times, you could change the loop count to 8 and not have to add any blocks at all. If you wanted to do this with the first approach to drawing a square, it would end up using 16 blocks and take much longer. Now you're starting to see why refactoring to write an efficient program can be really important and save time.